Hey, Roadrunners, Layla
and Andrew here with Guess a Song Challenge,
a Gold Chunker interview,
a skit,
and much more on this week's Roadrunner Report. Alejandra did a public service announcement with a surprise guest.
What did she talk about?
Her PSA included information about National History Day winners and fourth quarter. Let's see the clip.
I'm Elena.
I'm Alejandra.
And we have a little PSA. The last quarter of the school year started Monday the 18th. Eighth graders must have a 2.0 GPA. Good luck, Roadrunners.
The Half and Full Marathon is being hosted on Sunday, March 31st. Good luck, Roadrunners.
And lastly, Prescott also swept the individual performance competition as eighth grader Julia Gain took first place with her performance entitled Fred Rogers, Journey Through Television. And fellow eighth grader Lauren Pease took second with her performance of A Day in November about efforts to inoculate the citizens of Boston against smallpox during a 1729 epidemic. Also, 8th grader Dar Patel and 7th graders Jared Warder and Holden Puccinelli faced very tough competition in the individual website category. Jared created the site California's Gold Rush, the beginning of a state, and Holden created From the Ashes, a Forest Arises, the 1988 Yellowstone Fires. Dara took first place with her website, The Prohibition Movement, a Novel Experiment. The 7th graders Jifa Akwai and Saloni Bonsol took home first place in the very crowded group exhibit category for their project, The Lowell Mill Girls, inspiring women to turn tragedy into triumph. In the also tough individual exhibit category, 7th grader Eve Ukarnov won first for her exhibit, Rosalind Franklin, the unnamed heroine of DNA. Good job, Roadrunners.
Woo! Armando did a man on the street.
What was the question?
The question was, what are your plans for spring break? What are your plans for spring break, Andrew?
Just get some rest. What are your plans for the spring break?
I have a few basketball games, but other than that, I might just sleep in.
Let's see the students' answers.
Hi, I'm here with
Keith Cooper,
Daniel,
Roberto,
Tyrone,
Anthony,
Heather.
And what is your plan for spring break?
I'm going to go to sleep.
I got baseball tournaments.
I got a job.
Boats.
I'm going to San Jose.
Football practice.
Thank you for your answers. Hi, I'm here with
Omar.
And what is your plan for spring break?
Go to a water park.
That's cool. Thank you, Omar.
You're welcome.
Hi, I'm here with
Bianca.
And what is your plan for spring break?
Relaxing, sleeping, movies.
Thank you so much.
Dean Baker here with William Shewfelt, or the Red Power Angel. What inspired you to pursue a career in acting?
What inspired me to pursue a career in acting was one of my teachers, Mr. Braga. So Mr. Braga was very influential to me. The other was just having actors that I looked up to. So Theo James was one of them. He does like these divergent insurgent movies.
Okay.
But yeah, so it was just having different actors, different inspirations.
Okay. When did you own the role of Red Power Ranger?
I got the role of the Red Power Ranger, basically I was 20 years old and I was my third year into college, and I really, really badly wanted to get this role, and I was working very hard towards it. And I set this goal to do it within a year, because otherwise I would have been out of college. So I set that goal, and I worked really hard on it, and then I think it was in 2016 I got a call, and I booked the role. So, yeah.
How did you feel when you learned the news of getting the role?
Oh, man, exhilarated.
Okay.
Yes, it was so many months of hard work just coming to fruition, you know, so it was very, very exciting for me. My mom loved it too.
Did Prescott teach you any valuable lessons that you applied to, which made you successful?
None. No, I'm kidding. No, it taught me many, many lessons.
Okay.
I learned those lessons through the PE program. That was one of them. I learned about self-improvement and becoming better every day. Mm-hmm. The second lesson I really learned from Prescott was just to live without regrets. So if you really want to do something, just going for it. Because when I turned down doing that play that Mr. Braga had offered me, I regretted it so badly. And I knew that I never wanted to feel that again. So even if you're scared, go after it anyway, and you'll be happier in the long run.
What advice would you give to a student who wanted to make an impact?
That's a fantastic question. The advice that I would give to them is first to journal about what kind of an impact they want to make in the world. So think about what are they most passionate about, what do they really, really care about. The second thing I would advise them is to set a goal for that year, to do something towards that impact. So even if, let's say you wanna stop wars, let's say you really care about foreign policy and you want a more peaceful world. Well, when you're young, you can't stop a war immediately, but what you can do is you can start studying journalism and you could see if maybe you could get a journalism degree in college and you just slowly work your way up there. You can start writing articles and you can send those. So there's always things you can do to get closer to your goals.
Okay. Anything else you would like to add?
I love Prescott. Prescott Roadrunners for life. I'm wearing my blue trunks. This is the best school ever.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
E-journalism did a skit.
What does the skit concern?
The skit was about what not to do when heading to spring break.
Let's see the great acting.
Did you hear that? Did you hear that? It's the bell!
No, it's on me.
No!
I learned those lessons.
Done! Time to go to spring break!
I learned about spring break.
Andrew, guess what song this is?
Wannabe by Spice Girls.
Good job.
Why is this song playing?
We gathered 2 7th and 8th graders to guess various 90s songs.
Let's bounce to the clip.
Dean Baker here with another edition of Guess the Song Challenge. We have gathered 2 7th graders, Charles and Daniel, and we are going to test their knowledge of 90s music. Here comes the first song.
Oh, wait. This is literally just a high-tech baby, but it's just. Let's see. I know the song name, but
yeah,
I don't know
who it's like a song
it.
Name, but what's
okay? So what is it? They both got half a point.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know who sings it though. So
no, I don't know.
That was Vanilla Ice. And
oh, I should have known that.
Yes, it was Vanilla Ice. So 0.5 for each piece.
I should have known that.
Here comes the next song.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt
okay,
me.
Yeah. I know the song name. I don't know the. Okay, this is.
Okay,
I think this is What is Love, right?
That's, yeah, it's What is Love, but. It's
I don't know. I don't know who
Do
sings it.
Do you want
it.
To listen to a little more to see if you can get.
I don't know who sings it.
If you have Mr. Avalor, he plays this story in Wake Room. So that was What is Love by Hathaway.
What kind of name is that? Hathaway.
I don't know. Why did you ask his mom? So you both got half a point each.
I suck at this.
It's okay.
That's a nice song. Oh, I heard the song. It's good.
What is this song? Is it called Jump?
Jump high, jump low, jump high and low.
I think Charles got it, but he's like...
Jump.
Yes, that's correct. Wow. By whom? Whom?
So I don't know who by whom, I don't know.
Okay, that was Jump by Crisscross.
Crisscross.
You have a point for Charles. The fourth song out of the six is...
Oh, this is Macarena
by...
Okay. I should start researching my artists more.
Yeah,
I have
to.
No idea who sings like any of these. So
do you want to guess Daniel or Charles?
No, because I'm gonna get it wrong.
I don't know.
Okay, so that was
some Spanish dudes.
That was Machine by Los Del Leos.
Oh, I knew it was Spanish.
Del Leo, Los Del Leos. The fifth song is as following.
Here we go. My fine. Oh, this is. Isn't this by NSYNC? No, not. It's. No. I know this. Okay, this is. I want it. Backstreet Boys, I want it that way. I want it that way.
That's correct, the point.
Yeah.
So, ooh.
Yeah.
Okay, then the last song is.
This is by Britney Spears. This is Britney Spears, Hit Me.
Yeah,
one
like
more
Britney
time
Spears.
Or Hit Me Baby One More Time?
It's Hit Me Baby. Oh, it's Baby One More Time, but it's Hit Me Baby One More Time. So that's another point. Okay, the results are in.
I won. Oh, never mind.
Oh, good job.
You did. Nice job.
Oh, I did?
No, just kidding. Charles, Charles had a total of 4 points. Daniel had one. Dean Baker here with another edition of Guess the Song Challenge. Our two 8th grade contestants are Ashel and Elena. We are going to guess their knowledge of 90s music. Here comes the first song.
I'm scared. Oh, I'm...
Everybody dance now.
Everybody dance now.
By who?
Who got it?
Okay. I think feel like she said it first.
Are you
kidding?
We can do it.
Oh my god, it was living on Madagascar. We're watching it.
Hold on.
You started moving my hand.
Hold on. Ashel said it first.
I think Ashel said it first.
Alright, let's go.
So, any guess on who's the artist?
Oh gosh, I know Miss Coyce.
I have no idea.
That was CNC Music Factory?
Never heard of him.
Okay.
That's the only song I've heard of.
Yeah.
The next song.
Pretty Britney Spears. Macarena, right?
Not the Macarena. Nah, I don't know. This is some.
Ew, I thought that was so stupid.
Oh. I don't think we could like say stupid or something.
Oh, is that a curse?
Nah,
word?
No, no, we're kidding.
Any guess?
No, we have no guesses.
That was Vogue by Madonna.
Madonna?
Oh my gosh,
bro,
I'm
I love
so
Madonna.
Slow.
She's with Michael Jackson, right? They like collabed a lot, Madonna and Michael Jackson. Continue, next song. Oh, Hammer Time! Hammer Time!
Oh, I literally was like, what is it?
MC Hammer something. What was it? Hammer Time. I know what it is.
It was by MC Hammer.
Yeah.
You Can't Touch This.
Oh, You Can't Touch This.
He still got that.
Yeah.
I'm literally dying.
Wait, do I still have
Alejandro's a point? Like shaking. Right
2 points.
Half
let's go.
A point.
Half a point.
I have zero.
Elena.
Rock.
All Star by Smash Mouth.
Yeah.
No, give it to Elena. Come on.
I got Smash Mouth. He got the.
We don't do pity.
We don't do
pity. We don't do mercy.
Okay.
So a point, then half a point for Elena. Okay.
All right, half a point. Yeah, we don't know.
I feel like an uncultured swine. I do not know.
Is it by George Michael?
That was also by Madonna.
Oh, Madonna. Okay, I don't know why I thought that was George Michael.
The song was I.
Who's George?
It used to be my playground.
I never heard.
It was featured in A League of Their Own.
What are these irrevelant songs? I'm kidding. They're not irrelevant.
Whoa! I was like,
they're talented. Honestly,
I believe this is the last song.
Okay. Oh my god, I'm gonna lose.
Say a word. I don't know.
Genie in a Bottle by. I don't know. I don't know.
Do you have a guess on?
No.
That was Genie in a Bottle.
Is it by Madonna?
That was Genie in a Bottle by Christina Aguilera.
Oh my god, I'm so slow.
She's an actor, right? What is it ruining?
Guess the song challenge.
Oh, guess the song.
Single. I'm sorry. So the winner is Ashley with 3 points. You. Elena had one. Thank you for your time. And
good job, man.
Here comes the next
good job, bro. We're a good team.
Yeah, we're
go, Asher!
No hate.
Wait, I plug. Oh, subscribe to me at Asher Babarco. Content. All
yeah,
the time.
Follow my boy. Follow me on Instagram at Lena Tuna. You know, I gotta get them followers. I have like 400.
Angel interviewed new gold trunkers, Taylor Mitchell and Lexi Gomez.
Wow, there are so many students who have earned their golds this year.
I know. The amount of gold trunkers this year is unbelievable.
Let's go to the interview studio.
So I'm here with Taylor and Lexi, and I'm interviewing them for their gold trunks. So the first question is, what did you test on to earn your golds?
I tested on shuttle and my time was 56.
That's really good.
I tested ladder and I did 5 trips.
That's really good. When did you earn your golds?
I earned my golds on March 18th.
I earned mine on March 15th.
That's good. What were your emotions when you achieved this?
I was happy and like surprised, but also relieved because I didn't think I was gonna get them last year.
I was really relieved because last time I tested shuttle, I was only like 0.06 milliseconds off, and I thought I wasn't gonna get it because, yeah.
Do you believe you will earn your purples or get close?
I think I will at least get maybe like a few points, but probably not my purples because we don't have a lot of time left.
Yeah, I agree.
Okay, what inspired you to get your golds? Like who or what?
Like a lot of people, my friends, my parents, and PE teachers.
Oh, yeah, and Ms. Hill. Like all the people up there on the wall.
Okay. Are there any PE goals that you would like to achieve before the year ends?
I would at least want to get my first Chevron.
I want to beat my mile time.
What are you planning to get? Like, what are you trying to beat?
What am I trying to beat?
Yeah, no, what are you trying to get on your mile?
Like 6:10, 6:12.
That's a good time. So, yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, wrong hand.
We hope you have an outstanding spring break. Thank you for watching this week's Roadrunner Report.
Shh, stop talking. Pop your call. Do it.
So cringy.